Welcome, WordPress. This is Aryan from WordPress, and today I'm going to show you two different ways you can deploy a chatbot on a Framer website. One of them is completely free, and the other one requires Framer's basic subscription, but gives you a much more polished experience. So let's go ahead and check them out. So for our first example, the paid version, I'm using a one-page demo site for a fictional speaker company called Sonic. The site has some product sections, it has pricing, FAQs, and some general info. I wanted to help visitors with product questions and pricing and guide them towards making a better buying decision. Let's go to WordPress and start building our bot. Okay, so the first step is to head over to WordPress and you can create a new bot. So once the new bot has been created, you can go ahead and choose the type of agent you want this bot to be. I'll go ahead with Brand AI Assistant, as we are looking to answer some common queries and general stuff regarding the brand. To do this, we can simply add the website that we want to be indexed. Knowledge base is basically a collection of documents, websites, or tables that you want your chatbot to be answering from. You can add your website over here and select all the pages that you want to be indexed. And then we can also add some files over here, which should have some of our most asked questions for the bot's reference. This way the bot can answer things like, what's the price of the speaker? What's the battery life? Is it waterproof? And general questions around that. And once both of these things are done, we can go ahead and press next and create an agent. The WordPress Studio should take in all of your information, figure out what will be the best instruction for your chatbot, and overall the best conditions to deploy it. Give it some time, it should take in your knowledge sources and give you a chatbot that you can just simply upload to your website. Once the chatbot is set up, you can go ahead and change some aspects about it. I guess you would like to change the style of the bot to reflect your website's own design. I have a dark website with greenish hue, so I will just select this and save this configuration. Now, I would say everything is set up from our side and we are ready to take this to Framer. And to do that, you can simply head over to Share and select the embed code over here. And we're going to take this embed code to the Framer dashboard. Once you're in your Framer dashboard, you can head over to this top left button over here and select site settings. In site settings, you can head over to the bottom of this page to find custom code. Now, again, custom code is a setting that is available with the pricing plans of Framer. Do get that if you want to upload your chatbot as a dynamic thing that is available on every single web page. In this custom code, the embed code that we have copied from WordPress, we can just go and copy that here and let us make it beautiful and save it. We have a chatbot which has been deployed as a widget, which stays loaded on your website despite changing pages, and it should immediately show up on your website. So let's go ahead and publish it and check it out. And this way the chatbot should show up as a widget on your website and it should immediately start talking to you as your wish should do. So that's it for the first type of deployment. Now I'll see you in the second type of deployment where we'll deploy this chatbot for free. Now the caveat of uploading the chatbot to Framer for free is that the chatbot will not be really dynamic and stay active across different pages. And one major drawback is that you will only be able to add it as a static element as a embed website on one of your web pages. And in some circumstances, it can work pretty well. So for example, taking a Sonic example, it is a pretty text heavy product, which will require some assistance. But say for clothing, we don't really want to guide too much of our conversation with text. We want the users to be able to just get into the website and get into the flow of checking out different products. So, Minana over here, the bot that I have made, is a very good example of how you can deploy your chatbot on web page, and it can act as a assistant that helps you choose clothes and all. So the bot making process stays exactly the same as our Sonic website. You'll go to WordPress, add your website, add your instructions, upload some files, and deploy it, which should bring you back to this page again, where we can like change the theme of our chatbot to reflect what we are trying to do. Let's choose something different. So once the bot is ready, you can save the configuration, and we are gonna share it using the shareable link. Here's where the process gets a bit different. You will not be taking the embed code, but instead you'll be taking the shareable link. So you can copy this shareable link and meet me in Framer dashboard. We are in Framer. I'm not gonna touch the existing chatbot. I'll show you how you can bring in a new one. So we can select this, wherever you want a new section to come for the chatbot, go ahead and create a new section. I'm gonna delete this picture. So now we just need to add the website link that we got from WordPress as an embedded website on Framer. So you can do that by selecting insert and embed. And then we are just gonna drag this embed and pin it to this section over here. Now, once this embed is selected, select the URL type and paste your URL. That should immediately bring Minana over here. Inside Framer, when I add this embed, it can come off as a bit weird, and that's where the paid version is better than this. It is responsive out of the box, but over here you can just do simple things to make it work better for you. You can fix the width to be relative to the width of the web page and your height. So with this, you can just publish your website and check out the new website. Although I would say one good exchange of having your website deployed like this is that for a clothing website like this, users might want to keep records of their conversations, and deploying the chatbot as an embed lets the users go and check out old chats with the chatbot to see what was recommended some time back. So here's what it looks like in a full chat interface right on the page. A great option if you want a persistent chat experience without upgrading Framer. Now, both these type of chatbots are collecting and drafting concise summaries of the conversations users do. So with the chatbot deployed, you can monitor its behavior, maybe take decisions like controlling the AI spend or how much freedom you want your users to have. And that's pretty much it. I hope this video was helpful for you. I shall meet you in the next video. Until then, happy bot building.